I think a lot of Republicans are breathing a sigh of relief. I mean, I kind of, the way that I looked at it was that Beto didn't stand a chance and that Cruz was going to win. It was going to be close, but this is one of those times that the Democrats spend a lot of money in something that they don't really have a chance. You know, I'm thinking back to the special election where they spent millions and millions and millions of dollars to put John Ossoff, you know, 27-year-old man who's sort of like a filmmaker against like a seasoned...
who wasn't even from the area?
Right. Didn't live in the district. Yeah. I mean, which is hilarious. Which, you know, you kind of wonder if Twitter pressured that guy into marrying that girl when he was like, well, you know, are you engaged yet? And he was like talking to the CNN reporter.
Arranged marriages.
Yeah. And he was like, no, not yet. I guess I'll go call her. But the Democrats spend a lot of money in these races that they have no business being in. I mean, yeah, I mean, it's good to put somebody up. I mean, Beto's a very charismatic guy. I mean, I don't really know what he stands for beyond like kind of doing this a lot and driving and talking to some guy over here. But, you know.
But
I mean,
those ads were everywhere. You could not log on to anyone's Facebook account without seeing those ads day and night, way more than anyone else I have possibly seen. NBC also projecting now Republicans will control the Senate. And that was what was projected when we had Scott Rasmussen up.